tech jobs are the fastest growing, highest paying in our economy, we have to make sure that our girls and women are positioned to take advantage of those opportunities. I have dedicated nearly, you know, my entire career to addressing issues of equity in education. And if I'm honest, I think it was something that was sparked in me growing up, both in Brooklyn, New York, but also in Kingston, Jamaica. And I had this mom who instilled in me the importance of mentorship, as well as fighting for equity and making change. And she's also the person who sent me to an all-girls high school in Kingston, Jamaica. And that's where I saw the transformative power of all-girls learning spaces. And I think I brought that back. You know, that passion and that thinking, you know, when I started my career as a teacher and then later worked at the New York City Department of Education, where I had a chance to design and launch schools where issues of equity could be central. And it was during that journey that I actually had the chance to lead the team that designed and launched New York City's first ever high school focused on software engineering. And, you know, issues of gender and equity were central in that effort. And if I kind of connect the dots, it's what led me to actually be the CEO of Girls Who Code, focusing on gender equity the way that I am right now. We've talked about this move for me many times. And if I'm honest, I also said no to it many times. But I think I knew it was right. And it sounds crazy because we're in the middle of a pandemic, and who decides to take on a role like this in the middle of a health crisis? But I knew that I needed to step into this gap and do this work on behalf of our girls and women, especially our girls and women of color. I was a political organizer right after undergrad, and I actually had the same job that former President Barack Obama had, same organization. And I credit that role, you know, with all the skills that I was able to build and still use today: advocacy, organizing, knowing how to throw a proper event. As an educator, I think I bring a lens and a focus that is so important to equity work, you know, at a nonprofit. And Girls Who Code is the perfect intersection of, you know, work that's focused on girls and education. So for me, as a Black woman in this sector, I think the impact right now is that Black and brown girls see me and know that this is possible for them. It's representation, it's paying it forward, it's making sure that other Black women can step into leadership roles in the same way that I have. You know, mentorship and sisterhood, you know, central to the work that we do at Girls Who Code, and personal values that I hold dear. And I hope that that impact far surpasses this moment, and that these girls become the leaders of the future who advance this work and move it forward.